We all know the triangle inequality. It basically states that you go fastest from A to B in a straight line. That seems pretty obvious. However, this triangle inequality turns out to be really useful in the context of complex numbers, as you will learn in this video. So, what does it state? We have here vectors v1 and v2, and the sum of the two, v1 plus v2. So, the triangle inequality says that this distance over here is smaller than the sum of that one and that one. So going in a straight line is faster than going like this and like that. That's exactly what the triangle inequality states. So what does that mean for complex numbers? So the norm of the vector v1 plus v2 smaller or equal than the norm of v1 plus the norm of v2. Well, if you translate that to complex numbers, the norm of v1 plus v2 is the norm of the complex number z1 plus z2 smaller or equal than the norm of z1 plus the norm of z2. So how can you use that? For example, if you want to estimate the quantity norm z squared minus 5z, you can write it as norm of z squared plus the norm of minus 5z, then you have the norm of z1 plus z2. That's smaller or equal than the norm of z1 plus the norm of z2. Well, the norm of z squared is the same as the norm of z squared. You can do that, for example, using the polar form. And the norm of minus 5 times z equals the norm of minus 5 equals 5 times the norm of z equals the norm of 5 times the norm of z. And how can you use that? Well, if your norm of z is constant, if you are on some circle, then you can estimate the quantity z squared minus 5z, because on this circle, you know that z squared minus 5z is smaller or equal than norm of z squared plus 5 times the norm of z. And on the circle where the norm of z equals 4, for example, if you have radius 4, then norm of z squared equals 4 squared equals 16 plus 5 times 4 equals 20 equals 36. So such a triangle inequality allows you to estimate the norm of z squared minus 5z on a circle, for example. So you show that you don't know exactly how big it is, but you know that it's smaller than 36. You can also reverse the triangle inequality to get a lower bound. So how do you do that? Well, you know that the norm of z1 equals the norm of z1 plus z2 minus z2. So you add and subtract z2. And then you have here your z1 plus z2, and here you have your plus your minus z2. So that's smaller or equal than the norm of the first term plus the norm of the second term. Well, the norm of minus z2 is just the norm of z2. You can bring that to the other side over there. So norm of z1 minus z2 is bigger or equal than the norm of z1 plus z2, or if you write it the other way, a norm of z1 plus z2 bigger or equal than the norm of z1 minus the norm of z2. You can play the same game with z2. You write z2 equals z2 plus minus z1. You take these together and these together, and you know the norm of z2 plus z1 minus z1 smaller equal than norm z2 plus z1 plus norm of minus z1. Norm of minus z1 equals norm of z1, so you can bring this to the other side over there. Then you know norm of z2 plus z1 bigger equal than the norm of z2 minus z1. And take the minus sign out equals minus norm of z1 minus z2. Now, if you combine these two equations over here, then you have that norm of z1 plus z2 is both bigger equal than z1 minus z2 and bigger equal minus norm z1 minus norm z2. So combined, that means that norm of z1 plus z2 is bigger equal than the absolute value of z1 norm z1 minus norm z2. And that is the reverse triangle inequality. So you know something about the norm of z1 plus z2, and now that's smaller than something, but now you also know that the norm of z1 plus z2 is bigger than something. Well, how can you use that? Same trick. Norm of z1 z squared minus 5z is bigger equal than norm of z squared minus norm of 5z, so that equals norm of z squared minus 5 times the norm of z. And that yields, for example, if you are looking at norm of z equals 4, so if you look again at on your circle, did your quantity z squared minus 5 z, and you already knew that it was smaller equal than 36, but you also know that it is bigger equal than the norm of z squared equals 16 minus 5 times the norm of z equals 4, so that you get 16 minus 20 absolute value. So you also know that it's bigger equal than 16 minus 20 equals minus 4 absolute value equals 4. So you know your norm of z squared minus 5z is will be relying on your circle with radius 4, but you know that it will always be between 4 and 36 using the triangle inequality.